guys, and welcome to Magworks Screencasts. In this video, we'll show you how to configure the Order Editor extension for Magento 2. This will let you conveniently edit and manage any order info without having to cancel orders. So, let's get straight to the point and learn how the extension helps you modify order data. To reach the functionality, go to Sales, Operations, Orders. Here, select an order you wish to change, and click View to access order info. By default, if you select Edit to make changes to the order, the existing one will be canceled. So, after you make modifications, you'll have to create a new order instead. We don't need it. Thus, nope, no thank you. As you can see, order information is displayed in several blocks. In this one, you can change the following variables: date, status, and state. Then, click either Cancel or Submit to disable or enable the changes. The extension also enables you to modify account information. That's where you can select shoppers and assign them to specific customer groups. With the module, you get to edit billing address, shipping and handling information, as well as make changes to the ordered items, including price and quantity. In fact, you can easily add more products to the order upon the customer's request. After you click the Add Products button, a new grid will appear. Here, you'll be able to conveniently add any product to the existing order, as well as specify how many items you need to add. After you're done editing, press the Add Selected Products to Order button to include more items if required. Also, with the module, you can easily specify how invoices or credit memos, shipments, and other order data will be updated. To do that, go to Stores, Settings, Configuration. Here, choose Magworks, Order Management. Let's have a closer look at the Order Editor tab, which consists of three sections. In the first one, you can specify the way invoice and credit memos are updated. Thus, if you desire to keep the order's modification history, select Create New Invoice, if possible. If you don't need that data, choose the second option. Over here, in the second section, you can choose whether or not to return item to stock. This means that when you edit the quantity of the items in the specific order, the corresponding changes will be made to the stock data. And last but not least, you can choose to recalculate the shipping amount automatically. Now, you've got the full picture of the extension's functionality and know how to configure it. Stay tuned as more updates are on the way. Still got questions? Feel free to check out the user manual or contact our awesome support team.